Welcome to this new Inside Code video where we will see the bit matrix maxsum problem. So what does the problem say? It says, given a matrix of bits where each row represents a binary number, the goal is to get the greatest possible sum. And in order to do that, we are allowed to toggle rows and columns, interchanging ones and zeros. Create a function that returns the greatest possible sum. Know that you can perform any number of toggles you want, and here is an example. You can pause the video if you want to try solving it. Now let's start. In this problem, we want to get the maximum sum of our binary numbers. For example, in this matrix, we have the first row is equal to 13, the second row is equal to 25, the third row is equal to 14, and the last row is equal to 16, so the sum is 68. But we want to have the greatest possible sum, and for that, we can toggle the row or column we want. By toggling, we mean to interchange ones and zeros. For example, if we toggle the first row, which is 01101, it becomes 10010. If we toggle the first column, which is 1101, it becomes 0010. Okay, but now how can we maximize our sum? What can we do to make our sum bigger? For that, we will use a property in binary numbers that says that each bit is more important than the ones at its right. In other words, if we have two binary numbers with the same number of bits, one holds the leftmost bit is 1 and one holds the leftmost bit is 0, the first one will always be greater, no matter the remaining bits. Which means that when we find a row holds the first element is equal to 0, we toggle it, because it will always be worth to do so. So if we take our initial example, we can see that the first row and the third row start with the 0, so we toggle them. Now that we toggle the necessary rows, we need to toggle the necessary columns. But here, we don't do the same thing as for rows, because columns don't represent binary numbers, they just represent the values of a bit at a specific index, which means that all values in a column are important. So here our goal is to have the maximum number of ones in a column, and in order to do that, for each column, we count the number of ones and zeros, and if the column has less ones than zeros, we toggle it, so that we will have more ones than zeros. For example here, the second column, the third one, and the fourth one have less ones than zeros, so we toggle them. Now that we toggled all the necessary rows and columns, we just have to calculate the sum of our binary numbers, and we return the result. In BRIEF, our algorithm is divided into three parts. First part, for each row, if the first element is equal to 0, we toggle the row. Second part, for each column, if it has less ones than zeros, we toggle the column. Third part, we calculate the sum of our binary numbers and we return the result. But you can see that we need three additional functions, one to toggle a row, one to check if a column has less ones than zeros, and one to toggle a column. Let's see their code in JavaScript. First of all, you need to know that to toggle a bit, we can XOR it with 1, because 0 XOR 1 is 1, and 1 XOR 1 is 0. So to toggle a row at the index row, for each index I in the row, matrix of row I becomes equal to matrix of row I XOR 1. That's it. Now to check if a column has less ones than zeros, we create a function that takes the matrix and the index of the column as parameters. Then we create two counters, one to count the number of zeros, and one to count the number of ones. Then for each index I in the column, if it's equal to 1, we increment the ones counter, else, we increment the zeros counter. After the loop, we return the result of this comparison, nb ones smaller than nb zeros. Third additional function, the one to toggle a column, it takes the matrix and the index of the column as parameters. Then for each index I in the column, matrix of I column becomes equal to matrix of I column XOR 1. Now that we got our additional functions, we can make the one that will give us the greatest sum. N represents the number of rows and m the number of columns. First step, toggle the rows. For each row at the index I, if the element at the index 0, the first element, is equal to 0, we toggle the row by using the function we made. Second step, toggle the columns. For each column at the index I, we check if it has less ones than zeros by using the function we made. And if it's the case, we toggle it by using the function we made. Third step, we create a variable sum initialized to 0, then for each row in the matrix, we convert it to a binary string to be able to convert it to decimal, and we add it to the sum. At the end, we just return the sum we got. For the time complexity of this solution, in the worst case, we have to toggle each row, and we have n rows, and each one of them has m elements, so the first step costs O of n times m. Second step, when we toggle the colons, we also have to traverse all the elements of each column, so it's also O of n times m. Third step, to get the sum of the rows, we also have to traverse all the elements of each row, so it's also O of n times m. And repeating an O of n times m task 3 times gives O of n times m time complexity. Because 3 is a constant, it gets removed. For the space complexity, we didn't use extra space except for simple variables, so it's constant, O of 1. We arrived to the end of the video, I hope that you understood the solution. Don't forget to check the code in the first link in the description and to subscribe to the channel and to give me your feedback and comments. See you in another video.